We are in the chapter fractions, right? Yesterday, did I give any homework?
Yes, teacher, you gave.
Yes.
What
yes,
is the
teacher,
homework
you gave.
Here? Yeah, what is the homework?
Here's the ascending order and descending order.
Ascending order and descending
order. Okay, it was exercise. Okay, children, fine. It was exercise 1.3, right?
Yes, teacher.
Yes. Fine. Yeah? Let us check. Okay, this was finished, right? Comparison and ordering, I explained. We are here arranging like fractions in ascending and descending order. We are here, right? I explained you yesterday how to arrange the fractions in ascending and descending order.
Yes.
And we are working with only here like fractions. Okay, only like. Okay, so here like fractions means what? The fractions which are having the same denominator. So, when we are having the denominator same, then the smallest numerator will be your smallest fraction. And the biggest numerator, the fraction with the biggest numerator will be your biggest fraction. So, in that way, we are going to see the numerators and arrange them from the smallest to the biggest fraction. So, this is how we are going to arrange the fractions in ascending and descending order. Okay, so yesterday I gave this as homework, right? Exercise 1.3.
Yes.
1.3, sorry.
Yes.
So, yes. Now see here. Yes, dear, what happened? Fine, okay. Yeah, so shade two crayons in red and three in blue. Then shade five iron boxes in blue and three in yellow. Write and compare the fractions. Okay, you have to write the fraction and also compare the fraction. Comparing means what? Saying which is big and which is small. Yes or no, dear children? Compare means that. Okay?
Yeah.
Telling everyone their differences.
Yeah, fine. So, we have shaded the two crayons to be red and three crayons to be blue. So, what will be the fraction of red crayons? Yeah?
2.5.
Yes, exactly.
2.5.
So, what will be the fraction of blue crayons?
3 by 5.
Yes. I hope it is visible or no. I don't know because I cannot move this up. It's not going. Okay. It is 3 by 5, children. I am saying orally. Yeah. Okay. Now I have two fractions. One is 2 by 5 and one is 3 by 5. So here the denominators are same. So when you compare, you have to compare the numerators. So in that, which fraction is big?
3 by 5.
Smaller fraction. So here in the first blank, this should be bigger. See, it is greater than the second. So in the first blank, what should I get?
3 by 5.
Yes. 3 by 5 I should get. So 3 by 5. Yes, 3 by 5 is greater than 2 by 5. I hope everybody has done the same. Right, children?
Yes.
If any mistake, you can change it now quickly. Okay, no problem. Now, coming to bit B. In bit B, what you have to do? You have to shade the 5 iron boxes in blue color and 3 iron boxes in yellow color. So this is how we have shaded. Okay, if you have colored it, it's okay, no problem. Fractions of blue iron boxes, what it would be? How do you write fraction of blue iron boxes? We have
four
shaded
5 by 8.
Yes, 5 by 8. Okay, 5 by 8. Total is 8.
3 by 8.
Yes, fraction of yellow iron boxes is 3 by 8. Because we have shaded 3 in yellow color out of 8 boxes. So now we have to say in this which is big and which is small. So?
5 by 8.
5 by 8 is bigger. So in the first blank you are going to put 5 by 8 and in the second blank you are going to put 3 by 8.
Eight.
Yes. So 5 by 8 is greater than 3 by 8. Clear, children, all of you, the homework?
Yes.
Coming to the next question. Arrange the following fractions in ascending order. I told all of you to do A and B. I told C, I will explain.
Yes,
I told only that. A and B only I told you to do. Fine. Okay, now let us check the answers for A and B. This is in page number 62, dear all of you. Okay, in the reader. Arrange the following fractions in ascending order. Okay, this is your question. That is 2 by 5, 7 by 5, 1 by 5, 3 by 5, 19 by 5 and 4 by 5. Okay, so this is the first bit. So what will be your answer? So first, which number will come? Because here we have
1 by 5.
You have is 1 here.
1 by 5.
So 1 by 5.
2 by 5.
Then in the order.
And 1 by 5.
3
and
5
by
5.
4 by 5.
Then 7 by 5. 9 by 5. So this is how you are going to arrange the first bit in the ascending order. I hope it is clear for everyone, right?
Yes, teacher, it's clear.
Yeah.
Fine. Now, coming to bit B. Now, this we are going to arrange in the ascending order. Okay. So, now here also 1 is the smallest numerator we are having. So, 1 by 12. Then, it's 4 by 12. Then, it's 5 by 12. Then, it is 7 by 12. Then, it is 9 by 12. Then, it is 17 by 12. So, this is your homework part. Clear, everyone? I hope everybody got the same answer.
Yes.
Now, I am going to the descending order, which I told you to do the first two bits, right?
Yes, I did also descending
order.
Okay, if you were absent, you can do today. No problem at all. Okay, dear? Yeah, now I will go for the descending order and let us check the answers. Arrange the following fractions in descending order. Now I keep the bit C pending for you. I will do it after explaining. 34 by 91, 7 by 91, 1 by 91, 57 by 91 and 18 by 91. These are the fractions we have and we are going to arrange in descending order. Descending order, you all of you know that we have to arrange from big fraction to smaller fraction. Okay, so in this here figure is 7 by
91,
34 by 91, 18 by 91, 7 by 91 and 1 by 91.
I hope everyone got the same answer. Now coming to bit B. This is the question we are having. Again, we are arranging in descending, that is from big to small. So it's 32 by 20, 17, yes, 14 by 20, yeah.
2 by 20, 1 by 20, 2 by 20, 1 by 20.
Yesterday's homework part, I hope everyone got the same answer. So now we need to do the bit C in those two questions. Right, dear children?
Yes.
Yes. Now for that I want to explain. Then I will go for the bit C. Okay, so kindly all of you mute your phones and listen. Yeah. Now only I started the class. Now I should give you the homework and then I will explain, dear Tasbi.
No, she said that she wanted me
to give another homework.
Another homework I gave? Only this, yes. I gave yesterday.
No, no teacher, you gave.
Oh, what is that? Tell me. What is the homework? Tell me.
And convert the following mixed fraction to impure fraction.
Okay. Thank you, dear. So I will explain this and I will go for that. Okay, thank you, Tasbih. Fine, okay. Now I will go for, first I will complete the bit C, then I will show you that homework, okay? Yeah. See here, in bit C, you have all the numerators to be same. Yes or no, children?
Yes.
Okay. Now all of you see here. You have one pizza here. Okay. The pizza is cut into four pieces. Now can you tell me what is the fraction of each piece? How do I write the fraction?
One by four.
The fraction of each piece is 1/4. Clear?
Yes.
If the same one pizza I am going to cut into six pieces, then what will be the fraction of each piece?
1/6.
Okay, agree. 1/6. Now, again, the same pizza I am going to cut into eight pieces. Then what will be the fraction?
1/8.
Now all of you, the fractional part of your pizzas?
Yes.
Now see the part. See the part you have mentioned. This is 1/4. Agree all of you?
Yes.
Now I am taking and keeping it down. Okay, this is 1/4. Now this is 1/6. Agree all of you?
Yes.
So now I am taking and keeping it down. Okay, this is 1/8. Agree all of you?
Yes.
It is 1/8, so I will keep it down now. Now I am naming these pieces, okay? First piece as A, second piece as B, third piece as C. Now in piece A, B and C, can you tell me which piece is smaller?
C is smaller.
Yes or no?
Yes.
Which piece is bigger?
A.
Now, if I want to arrange these pieces from smaller piece to bigger piece, how I am going to arrange? First,
from C to A.
Then B will come. Then A will come. Right?
And then A will come.
Yes. So what fraction is C representing? 1/8. Right?
1/8.
Yes.
Yeah. What fraction is B representing?
1/6.
And what fraction is A representing?
1/4.
Now tell me, children, here what you are observing. The denominator, see, when the numerators are same, the bigger denominator is the smaller fraction. Understood, everyone? Now I showed you in the example also. The bigger denominator, as you increase the number in the denominator, the fraction becomes smaller and smaller. Okay? So when the numerators are same, when the denominators are same, you know how to do it. When the denominators are same, the smallest numerator will be the smallest fraction. Okay, the fraction with the smallest numerator will be the smallest fraction. But when the numerators are same, you have to see the biggest denominator. Where the biggest denominator is there, that will be the smallest fraction. And where the smallest denominator is there, that will be the biggest. You can see that 1/4. 4 is the smallest denominator we are having, but it is bigger in size. Yes or no?
Yes.
Now understood. Yes. Okay. Now if I want to arrange the same from bigger to smaller, so how I will arrange? First I will put A then B, then C. So A is representing 1/4, B is 1/6, C is 1/8. So the biggest one is 1/4 and the smallest one is 1/8. Now have you all understood? when the numerators yes. are same, whatever it may be, it is yes. not only one I am talking, it is a, it could be any number other than one, okay? It can be two, but it should be same all. How you have the denominators all same, any number in the same way, in the numerators also must be same. Is that clear? Okay,
yes.
So when the numerators are same, the biggest denominator will be the smallest fraction. The fraction with the biggest denominator will be the smallest fraction. And the fraction with the smallest denominator will be the biggest fraction. Is that clear, all of you now?
Yes, teacher. Yes, teacher.
I will go for... Now I will go for our bit C. Yeah, we have done here A and B, right? Now I am doing bit C. Yes, tell me now what will come here in ascending. Means we are arranging from small to big. So which fraction
will
come?
1/4.
1/4.
Why 1/30 will come? Because that is having
because
the biggest denominator. That will be the smallest fraction. Okay, dear children. So 1/30. Then.
Okay.
1/30. After 1/9. 1/13. 1/9. 1/13. 1/9. 1/9. 1/4. So this is your ascending order. Arranging from small to big. So 1/30 is the smallest piece you are going to get. The fraction will be the smaller size. And 1/4 is the smaller, bigger size. Is that clear, everyone?
Yes.
Yes. Okay.
Yes.
Now we go for the question number 3 with the bit C which is pending. Here we have already solved the two questions. Now coming to bit C. Now tell me, I have to arrange in descending order, that is from big to small. What will come first?
1/2, 1/10, 1/14.
Means what?
Because
the fraction with the smallest denominator will be the biggest fraction. Okay, so 1/2, then 1/10, then 1/29, then 1/40. Okay, it's the bit C, ascending order, descending order. Clear now?
Yes.
Have you all copied the answers?
Yes, sir. I cannot see the screen. I cannot see it.
Leave and join, my dear. You leave and join again, Asil.
Okay. Teacher, yeah. Right. Write bit C.
You want in ascending order, I will show first ascending and then I will go for descending. Okay? Yeah.
Okay.
This is the for ascending order. Okay, all of you, in question number 2, bit C, this is the answer. Anyone wants to take it down, they can take it. Quickly, because you are having only 4 fractions here. Be quick. Either you can note it down in the reader, later you can write in the notebook.
Teacher, I already finished all.
Okay, if you have finished, well and good, dear.
Okay.
Those who have finished, don't write it again. If you have not finished, take it out.
I don't get the explanation for C because I didn't understand.
Here I said that, who's this?
Hannah.
Hannah. I said, you are seeing here the denominators same in the question bit A. You were not there when I was explaining.
No, I was here.
Okay, fine. Here, I said the denominators are same in the first yeah. bit, right?
Yeah.
When the denominators are this, when the denominators are same, the fraction with the smallest numerator will be the smallest fraction. Okay, clear, Hannah?
Yeah, that's ascending order.
Yes, that is ascending. Yeah, small s means we are seeing in the numerator. In the numerator, which is small, that will be the smallest. And which is big, that will be the biggest. Okay, there is no confusion. When numerators are, sorry, when denominators are same. Okay?
Yeah, I know. I meant C.
Okay, now listen here. Now listen here. It is opposite of this, what you have done in A and B. That I meant to say. It is the opposite of what you have done in A and B. Here what you are telling, the smallest numerator will be the smallest fraction. Here you have to say in opposite. The smallest denominator will be the biggest. There it is the same. The smallest numerator is the smallest fraction. Whereas here, the smallest denominator is the biggest fraction. Clear, Hannah?
Yeah, I understand.
The smallest denominator, the smallest, if the numerators are same, if the numerators are same, the smallest denominator is the biggest fraction. And the biggest denominator is the smallest fraction. You have to say the opposite of that. Clear? The opposite of that, what you have done in A and B. Clear, Hannah?
Yes. Thank you, teacher.
Yes, have you all copied bit C now?
Yes, teacher.
Yes, teacher.
We finished.
One second. It is... Yes, descending order. Finished, everyone?
No, teacher.
Yes.
No.
1/2, 1/10. Here also, when the numerators are same, the fraction with the smallest denominator is the biggest fraction. And the fraction with the biggest denominator is the smallest fraction. So in this way you have to arrange. So 1/2 will come in the order. So now you have to go arrange this in order. After 2 it will be 10, 29 and then 40 in the denominator. From biggest to smallest.
Are we supposed to write this in the notebook?
Finish teaching.
Yeah. That Yasin is muted.
What?
What's that sound? Yasin, please mute your phone. Yes, right, my dear. Yasin, please mute your phone, dear. It is open, dear. It is muted. Yasin, it is completely. Now it is muted. Please mute it.
I am muting it. Okay, teacher, this is no. Not me, I was muting it.
Mute it now.
No, he was unmuted.
I can see, Yasin, you are still unmuted.
Not me, teacher. Wallah, I muted.
Shall I share in screen? Shall I show you here that you have been unmuting? Mute it, Yasin, now. Yeah. I hope everyone copied. So now, which I gave yesterday to convert mixed fractions to? Tell me, Tasbi.
Teacher, I didn't finish.
Improper fraction.
Which I gave the homework? Okay, fine, dear. The before one which I gave, you said from conversion.
Convert mixed fraction. Mix it to improper fraction.
Okay, fine. I hope everybody finished this question. 1/2, 1/10, 1/29, 1/40. Okay.
No.
Why? Yes. What happened? Quickly.
Teacher, can you remove the...
Here nothing is there what it has been there. Only see and answer. But the question and answer are still visible for you. Okay.
Teacher, this is very easy.
Yes, I have given much time now. I will go for what?
Teacher.
Yeah. Only D and last 2 bits are the homework.
D and E only.
Okay, fine. Fine. D and E. Mixed fractions to improper, right? Yes, D is 11, 3 by 7. Okay? Now come on, check all of you. 7 multiply 11 plus 3. It should be 77 plus 3. So what is the answer? 80. Right, children?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, 80. What is it? Write in the numerator now.
80 by
and
80 by 7. Teacher, 80 in the numerator and the denominator we keep 7.
Yes, so 80 in the numerator and in the denominator we write 7. So this is your D. Now E. E is 21 by 4. So now 4 multiply 20 plus 1. So 4 multiply 20 is
80.
80
81 will be in the denominator.
Yes, it is 81 in the numerator and 4 in the denominator. So this was your homework. Now all the homeworks I checked, right?
Teacher.
Yes. So, we have done this mixed fractions to improper fractions. Clear everybody. Then we have completed exercise 1.3 and we have seen how to arrange the fractions when the numerators are same and the denominators are also same. Like fractions also and the numerators are also same. Right, children? So, now we will go now to the next exercise. One second. Descending order. Yeah, addition of like fractions. Okay, this is also there in your reader, children. So please don't write anything in your notebook. Okay, later you can study from the reader. So these are addition of like fractions. I told that in this book we are going to do all the operations only with the like fractions. Like fractions means what? The fractions which are having the same denominator. Okay. So what is given here? To add like fractions, just add the numerators. What you have to do? Just add the numerators. Okay. Only add numerators. Don't add the denominators, dear children. Okay. Don't add the denominators. You will write the denominator as it is. Same. Okay. You are not going to add the denominator. You are going to just add the numerator. So let us see here examples. Okay. Add the following like fractions. You can see that the first one you have 4 by 9 plus 2 by 9 is equal to, they have added 4 and 2. 4 plus 2 is how much? 6. But they have not added the denominators. They have not added 9 plus 9, 18. They have not written here. They have written only 9. So the denominator you are going to take as it is, because it is telling, denominator tells the number of parts in one whole. It represents the total parts. So you are not going to add them. Understood, children? You are going to add only the numerators, but not the denominators. Denominator you are going to write same. Yeah? Yes, children, it is clear?
Hello?
Yes. Okay, coming to second bit, you can see you have here 1 by 7 plus 3 by 7. What you are going to do here? You are just going to add the numerators, 1 and 3. So how much? 1 plus 3?
4.
It is 4.
4
by and denominator 7. You are going to keep the same, 4 by 7. Clear?
Clear, teacher.
And in the third example, 8 by 12 plus 4 by 12 is equal to, again you are going to add the two numerators only. 8 plus 4, how much you got? 12. And the denominator you are going to keep the same. 12.
Yes.
Who got 12. Here? The numerator and denominator both same. 12 by 12. Here 12 by 12 is nothing but 1. It means
yes.
Yeah?
I cannot see the screen.
This. Who is this? Cannot see the screen.
Yes.
Are you able to see the screen, dear?
Yes.
Okay, no problem. I will share once again. Seal, I will share once again just to see, check now. If still you are not able to see the screen, then you have to leave and join again. Now, are you able to see, Asil?
No, still.
Means there is some problem at your side. Just check it, okay? Yeah. Now, here see, 8 plus 4 is equal to 12. 8 plus 4 is equal to 12. And we are going to keep the same denominator. We are not going to add the bottom numbers, dear children. Please keep it in mind. When you are adding, maybe you will be adding the numerators and denominators because there is a plus symbol there. No, you are not going to add the bottom numbers. You are going to add only the top numbers. 8 plus 4. You are going to add and then put and keep the same denominator which is there in both the fractions. It will be same, okay, 12. Now here I got the numerator and denominator to be same, okay. When numerator and denominator to be same, the value will be 1. It means that 12 by 1, 12 means it is 12 divided by 12. I am taking the 12 inside and I will divide the 12 with 12. So how many times it will go? 12, 1s are 12 minus 0 is the remainder. So what is the answer? Quotient I got 1. Okay.
One.
So 12 by 12 is 1. So when you are adding the fractions, if you happen to get the numerator and denominator same, then you have to write equal to 1. Clear? But not in other cases. Okay. When only these two to be same, when numerator and denominator to be same, we will write its value to be 1. Clear, children? Addition?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Now, this is one more example where we are adding the addition of whole number and a fraction. Okay. We are adding the whole number and a fraction. 1 plus 1 by 2. 1 plus 1 by 2 will be how much? Directly we are going to write. See? 1, 1 by 2. As a mixed fraction. You are seeing this is a mixed fraction. How you are going to write a whole number and a fraction together? You will just remove the plus symbol and you write it together. That's all. 1 plus 1 by 2. 1 plus half is equal to 1 and a half. 1, 1 by 2. Okay, 5 plus 3 by 4 is 5 3 by 4. 7 plus 1 by 4 is 7 1 by 4. Like this you are going to write. Easy, right children?
Yes, teacher, it is easy.
Yes, okay, we are.
Fine. Very hard? Good.
Oh, I said very easy.
Okay, easy. Fine. Okay, can you take out this exercise 1.4 you are seeing? After 1.3, maybe after 2-3 pages you have. Can you tell me one of you the page number? Please.
Page number 66.
Add the following like fractions. Homework. Okay? Only this. Add the following.
This all.
Only A. With A, others we will do tomorrow in the class. Okay?
Okay.
So
okay.
What is the page number, dear?
66. Teacher, we will do A and B and C.
No need. Only do A. Yeah, this all you will do. A, B, C, D, E, F you will do. You will complete problem number 1. Okay?
Okay.
No. I said here, see, only number 1. Fine?
Okay, teacher. Fine. Thank you.
Okay, bye-bye. Have a nice day.